Kids, remember to show kindness this holiday season. A smile and friendly hello go a long way.
Did you know that it's physically impossible for a pig to look into the sky?
I didn't. I wonder if they even get a chance to look at the stars.
Speaking of stars, let's talk about how we can keep the stars of our school safer. There will be a slight chance change to the morning drop-off beginning Monday, December 6th.
Cars will stop and let their students out before the gate inside the elementary playground just in front of the single pine tree on the northeast corner of the elementary.
This is for all elementary and middle school drop-offs. Once you drop your student off, please exit out of the gate to the right. Do not drive through the staff parking lot. The time, please stay the same at 7:50.
Thank you for being flexible and keeping our students and staff safe.
For lunch today, we are having macaroni and cheese, breadstick, peas and carrots, fruit and milk. Friday's lunch will be changing from pizza to pulled pork due to delivery issues.
Students and staff, don't forget to wear your new Turkey Run shirts tomorrow. Here is today's joke of the day, followed by Lexi with today's forecast.
What do you call a boomerang that won't come back? A stick.
For today's forecast, you can expect warmer weather with a high of 61. Clouds will come and go today, so hopefully you can enjoy a little sunshine today at recess.
Saying when people have different points of view. When it's time to synergize, you should work with people who have different ideas than you to come up with innovative solutions.
Stephen Covey once said, if two people have the same opinion, one is unnecessary. I don't want the same opinion. I don't want to talk to communicate with someone who agrees with me. I want to communicate with you because you see it differently. I value that difference.
From Mrs. Bull's class, Brantley Smith. Have it too, begin with the end in mind. Brantley has worked hard on learning to write his name. He practiced and never gave up. He loves to learn and works hard to make that happen. From Mrs. Shannon's class, Knox Paxton. Have it one, be proactive. Knox has worked hard over the course of the year to improve his behavior. He works hard to walk nicely in the halls, sit quietly at his desk, be helpful, and work with other students in his class. For Mrs. Jones's class, Autumn Worth, Habit 4, Think Win-Win. At the fall party, another student got out during musical chairs. When the student became upset, Autumn willingly gave up her seat and let the other student have it. For Mrs. Wade's class, Callie Bennington, Habit 3, Put First Things First. Callie always listens to directions and gets her work done first. She is able to focus on what's important before she plays or has fun. From Mrs. Lawson's class, Charlie Hammonds and Jake Lowe, Habit 3, Put First Things First. Charlie and Jake always put first things first. They are prepared first thing every morning. They know they have to listen to their teacher, then work. They work, then play. Charlie and Jake focus on what is important. From Mrs. Tidwell's class, Javelin Wallace, Habit 3, Put First Things First. Javelin is a very responsible student. She prepares for class every day and works hard to put first things first and do her best work. Mrs. Tidwell is so proud of her. For Mrs. Conley's class, Hope Jeffers, Habit 3, Put First Things First. Hope always puts her work before play. She always tries her best in everything she does, even when it is hard. Hope also always has a happy, positive attitude. For Mrs. Barger's class, Kevin Thompson, Habit 3, Put First Things First. Kevin puts first things first. He works hard, stays focused, and finishes his work on time. Way to go, Kevin. From Mrs. Mathis's class, Maddox Davis. Habit 1, be proactive. Maddox has been working hard in class to have a good attitude and improve his math skills. He has a goal to make great grades and wants to know how he can do better next time. Way to go, Maddox. From Mrs. Hansen's class, Marissa Brown. Habit 2, begin with the end in mind. Marissa sets goals and makes a plan to accomplish them. She wanted to use her class dojo points to have lunch with the teacher. So she had worked really hard to earn points by bringing her supplies to class, helping others, and participating in class. Then she saved the points until she had enough for that reward. She did not spend any of the points, even when she saw classmates using theirs for other rewards. She made a plan and stuck with it. Way to go, Marissa. For Mrs. Crane's class, Luke Montell. Habit 6, synergize. Luke values others' opinions. He also works well with other people and works well in groups. For Ms. Doss's class, Vinny Bonomo. Habit 3, put first things first. Vinny is focused and works hard every day. She always gets her work completed and turned in on time. Vinny takes pride in the work that she does. Keep it up. For Mrs. Martin's class, Tristan Marlowe. Habit 3, put first things first. Tristan spends time on the things that are most important. He is fully engaged in class discussions and always likes to raise his hand in class. Added bonus, he is so kind. For Mrs. Simpson's class, Colton Jean. Habit 1, be proactive. Colton has been working so hard in math and science. He focuses and gets his work done. He also asks questions when he needs help. Colton has also been working hard on positive behavior and supporting other students in class. For Mrs. Powell's class, Jason Donovan. Habit 1, be proactive. Jason is a hard worker who always comes to school with a smile for his teachers and his classmates daily.
At this time, would you please stand as our scriptwriters lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Have a great day at TRES.
Together we spent and gained success.